Hello and welcome to the Nero video tutorials. Today, we'll learn about advanced movie. With advanced movie, we'll be able to create professional level videos with more helpful tools. The interface of advanced movie is similar to the express one. The advanced timeline is ideal for detailed video editing with multiple organized tracks for precise control, including multiple video tracks, effect track, audio, and music tracks. Here are some tools that can help you with video editing. We'll introduce them in the next video. These icons are the most frequently used tools. First, standard tool. You can use it to drag, select, arrange your video clips. Then it's rectangular marquee. It's ideal for multi-selection like this. Next, the cutter. It lets you trim your clips. When using the cutter, click on the desired position in the clip, and it will be split into two parts at that point. Finally, the magnet. When the magnet is off, you can move your clips freely. It can be hard when you try to align clips together. When it's on, your clips automatically snap to the nearest reference point, which makes alignment easier. Now we know the interface, let's start a project by importing files. Similar to the Express movie, we drag the clips into the target timeline. Let's put all main clips into track video 1. Don't forget to check the movie options before start. We can see this clip doesn't fill the frame. Open the effect palette. All basic information of the chosen clip is in this tab. Choose scale. Set the template to scale and fit. You'll see the video is well fit to the frame now. You can also play with these settings for more interesting results. Drag a video effect to a clip to apply. It's the same as in Express mode. You can apply several effects to one clip. What's different from the Express mode here is that you can see the effect settings clearly in the tab, and of course you can make adjustments easily. Or you can delete the effects you don't want. Applying transitions is also simple. Drag to place or replace a transition between clips. Adjust the duration and position by dragging the transition field. The adjustment is more flexible in this mode. Tap backspace delete to delete. Now, let's jump into some exciting editing on the video tracks. Here's a slide bar that controls the display ratio of the timeline. This helps you work comfortably with your clips. Zoom out to quickly handle longer clips with broader edits, or zoom in for precise frame-by-frame adjustment. The Master Effects track lets you apply video effects globally to all clips in the timeline or target specific timeframes. Anything covered by this master effect gets the applied effect. As for video tracks, remember this basic rule: the upper track covers the one beneath it. Knowing that, we can create very interesting effects, like montage or flashbacks. Now, I'd like to add some text on top of the flashbacks. Right-click any of the track's name, choose Add Tracks, and Video. Now we have a new video track. We can add text or clip arts on a video track. Simply drag a text effect to this empty track, set the text style, and place it to the position you like. Let's see what we've got. Now the sound of the train ends suddenly. I don't like it very much. How can we extend the sound while keeping the clip length? Right-click this clip and unlink its audio. Now the audio is detached from the clip, and we can edit it without making our video clips a mess. Go to the audio effect and make it fade out gently. Finally, let's add a background music to this video. And our first advanced movie is done.
As the clock strikes 12, a quiet plea, Lord, take my heart and set it free.
Thank you for watching. Hoping to see you in our next tutorial.